Well, Justin, a huge night for you in front of the home fans. Three goals.
Yeah, I mean, the boys have been riding me for a while here. I've been a little snake bitten, but anytime you see a couple go in, it's always nice. And, you know, I got to give credit to the boys, especially my line mates. You know, Gab and Mims did a good job finding me all night. I had plenty of looks and just fortunate enough to cash in on a couple.
Yeah, how frustrating has it been for you over the last number of weeks trying to get them goals, but just being unlucky?
Yeah, I mean, I've been through slumps before, but nothing anywhere near this. You know, the thing is, I felt like I was playing good hockey and I was getting my opportunities, but, you know, they just weren't falling for me. And, you know, sometimes that's hockey and you just got to stick with it and, you know, trust your instincts and hopefully nights like this happen and get you back on track.
And of course, with the injuries the team's had, you've had to work hard in that defensive role as well. Do you think with Mastro being back tonight, and it gives you that ability to kind of go forward a little bit more and try and grab them goals?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, Mastro's a great player. You know, he's a piece we've been missing for a long time, and we've been asking a lot of our defensemen lately, and they've been doing a great job. You know, they're double shifting every single night. You know, playing big minutes, but doing a good job. So hopefully with Mass back, you know, he'll bring a little experience, a little poise back there, and help give the boys a little bit of a rest.
Yeah, and of course, the midweek game against Sheffield's maybe one to forget, but that's two league wins now in a row for the Dundee Stars, and of course their first conference points of the season. It's something to build upon.
Yeah, I mean, obviously we weren't pleased. Felt like we played two good periods against Sheffield, and you know, just kind of got away from the system in the third. And, you know, we got a young team. We just got to learn from those games and hopefully build and get stronger. But anytime you can string two together, especially with a conference win, it's something to build on. And, you know, we just got to keep pushing forward. We're getting to a crucial point in the season where, you know, we got to get wins, whether it's against Edinburgh or a top-end team. We got to show up every night and work for 2 points.
And of course, you got man of the match tonight, but a trip to Sheffield during the week before a huge game against Fife. Are you feeling the pressure going into that one now with the fans?
No. Last time I was in Fife, I got a great reception. You know, I spent 2 good years there, enjoyed my time there, and I was always treated with class there. And last time we played there, they gave me a good ovation. So a lot of good memories there, but, you know, I got a few buddies that are still over there, and you know, I'd love to get 2 points against them for sure.
Well, best of luck this week, Justin, and congratulations on the hat trick.
Much appreciated.
Well, Omar, the first conference points of the season for the Stars, and a huge victory tonight.
Yeah, it's just it's too bad it happens towards the summertime. In the summertime, but no, it's a good team effort. Some great individual performances. That guy stepped up, but overall, obviously, we needed this win tonight. It was, for us, it was the biggest game as of the season, and there's going to be a lot of big games coming up, but this one, we needed to kickstart the conference, you know, after losing 4 in a row to get some points and now get the ball rolling.
Yeah, in terms of the result as well, good for confidence following the disappointing result against Sheffield midweek.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's a weird one because, you know, you look at the last 3 games and I think there's just 15 minutes of really bad hockey we played. And the thing with us is when you play a team like Sheffield, you play bad for 15 minutes. You get out of your system. They hurt you. They make you pay. And, you know, they scored four goals. I thought maybe one, you know, there was goaltender interference, but the ref saw otherwise. But, you know, I think if that didn't count, maybe it would have been still 5-2, but obviously it counted. That's, I mean, obviously they're the referee, so they make the call, and we went, fortunately we gave up another one. So all in all, over the last 3 games, 9 periods, I thought just 15 minutes of really bad hockey. Tonight there were Spurs where I thought Edinburgh took it to us, and I thought they played well at times, especially in the second period where they had a lot of momentum, and we killed it off, and obviously we got the result.
Yeah, I mean, there's some performances to talk about tonight. We could start off with Travis Fullerton, though. As you say, when Edinburgh had their chances, he was there to prevent them going in, wasn't he?
Yeah, I thought both goalies played well. Travis was Travis. You know, he made some key saves in the third, especially. First period, he was not much action except for that play that, you know, we thought it was high stick, and we have to learn as a team to keep playing whether it was or wasn't. It's irrelevant. You got to play to the whistle, and that's a mistake that we'll have to correct. But you know, second period played great, and third period he saved us. And, you know, I thought Shigalo had a good game too. I mean, he made some really nice saves, especially in that second when we had a power play and we had great looks, and he made a few kind of miracle saves. So, so all in all, we got a good display of goaltending tonight, that's for sure.
And we must talk about Justin Fox, of course. You brought him in to score goals, Omar, and of course injuries have seen him at times maybe have more of a defensive role in the team, not through choice, of course, but Mastro back tonight, and he's managed to get three goals for you.
Yeah, Foxy, I mean, I think he was a bit snake-bitten for a while. He got chances, and I think that's why, you know, I was positive with him, and, you know, as even himself, he kept positive because he knew he had chances. And sometimes when you're a goal scorer, you know, as long as you still get chances, you're fine. And he was having those chances. And, you know, the good thing about Foxy is that if he doesn't score, he does something else to help the team. And that's why we brought him in. So, you know, for the past few games, even if he wasn't playing great offensively, at least he was playing really good defensively. And I'm really happy to see him score three goals. A hat trick. Anytime you're happy that you know one of your top guns gets three goals, but you know I thought their line controlled most of the game. I thought they had created a lot of chances, and I liked the way they moved the puck on the power play. And to go back to Mastro, it was just key to have him, give other guys rest. I think he has better to offer us, and I thought he had a good game. So that just shows how highly I rate him, and I think he's just going to get better throughout the next few weeks, you know, getting used to this speed again, and it's great that he comes back and we get a win.
Yeah, and you talk about the huge run of conference games that are coming up. It's handy to have him back and Foxy in that scoring form going into these crucial games.
Yeah, I mean, it's massive to get a, you know, we scored four against Manchester and fifth in an empty net tonight. We scored four again, so. You know, in the league, last two games, we lost obviously seven in a row, and now winning two in a row in the league, it's good to now we won after the Manchester game. We talked about not taking a step back, and tonight we took another step forward, so it's good. And hopefully we get other guys. You know, if Foxy can have a hat trick, you know, this game, and I hopefully he keeps going. And some guys, I think they're, you know, they're going to get their chances too. And I think you saw tonight a lot of them had chances, and hopefully now, you know, they keep going to the net hard, and hopefully they get rewarded.
Yeah, well, a game against Sheffield midweek before a huge crucial game against Fife Flyers next Friday night.
Yeah, it's a tough one to prepare. There's no secret. I mean, we're going to go in, and obviously, like any game, we're going to try to win. But listen, it's hockey. You never know. Maybe we get few bounces in the first, and you know, we make it a tight. You know, make it, if we get up two or three, you know, lucky bounces, or we have a really good start. Maybe we have a series, but you know what? We have to play the right way. We have to keep stringing that momentum. We had 15 bad minutes cost us the game on Tuesday, but we got to get back to our Stars hockey, our brand of hockey, and hopefully we can perceive that in our conference form and also in the league form.
Yeah, and we'll give a shout out to the fans tonight. A good turnout as well for a Friday night game against Edinburgh Capitals.
Yeah, it was a great turnout again. It was three games in this week. I mean, Sunday, Wednesday, Friday. So it just shows the commitment from the fans. And it was great to see them in numbers. And to get that teddy bears on the ice early was great to see. And you know, it was good to see Foxy have that big smile, because I think he even called in the locker room, "I'm gonna get the teddy boys," and he got it. So it was great to see all those teddy bears donated to a good cause. And you know, as I said a million times, I mean, we want to be a team that's really part of the community. Anything that we can do to help, it's beneficial for us, but most importantly, you know, the charities.
Well, congratulations on the win, Omar, and best of luck next week.
Thank you.